During my last two videos that I released on Intel stock, I saw a slew of comments referring to AMD. AMD is the better stock. AMD is the better investment. Intel is a dying company and they're going to be irrelevant sometime soon. Intel is a bad investment. AMD is the best investment. Guys, let's answer these questions in today's video. We're going to do a head-to-head comparison of AMD and Intel stock, and we're actually going to look at the facts here as opposed to just pure opinion and hunches and all that kind of stuff. Let's look at the facts to figure out which of these two stocks is actually the better investment today. Now, in this video, we're going to compare everything from the market caps of the company to their growth to their balance sheet to every aspect that I think is relevant here to help us figure out which stock is actually a better investment. Now, I have a good hunch that you guys are going to enjoy this video, and if you do, just consider hitting that like button down below. And if it does interest you, I want to make a similar video like this on other industries. I'm thinking Visa and MasterCard is actually a really good one to compare because they're such closely related companies, and people always have a question on whether Visa is a better investment, MasterCard is a better investment. So if you guys like this style of video, let me know in the comment section down below, and I can actually make this into a thing where we do this for other industries and other stocks as well. Okay, so since this video is a video to really compare which is the better stock, better investment, let's start off by looking at the charts for these two companies and comparing them over a few different time frames. On the 1 year time frame, AMD has blown Intel out of the water. It has returned 155% versus Intel a measly 3%. And really, this just got more extended in the last couple of weeks as AMD reported strong earnings and just shot higher, while Intel reported disappointing news on their earnings, which caused their stock to go lower. Now, on the 5 year time frame, things look even worse for Intel. It's at a respectable 67% gain, which, guys, honestly, not too bad for 5 year returns. But when we look at AMD, oh man, AMD is at a 4,600% gain in this time period. But now, if we look at the maximum time frame here, it may surprise you. Intel is actually well ahead of AMD, and if you happen to be in the company all of these years, Intel is over a 10,000% gain, and AMD is at a 1,900% gain. So clearly, looking back, Intel has been the overall better performer by miles. But times are changing, businesses are evolving, and it raises the question: is this AMD's opportunity to finally turn things around here and steal market share from Intel, profits from Intel, and all this other kind of stuff in this very competitive market? So as of recording this video, here's a side-by-side comparison of some high-level stats on each stock. Intel is currently trading at $48.57 a share, whereas AMD is trading at $86.71 a share. But this doesn't really matter all that much because the share price alone is meaningless when determining the value of a company. The next line, market cap, is what we really need to look at. Intel is at a market cap of $206.5 billion, and AMD just surpassed the $100 billion market cap. So AMD is half the size of Intel here from a value perspective. But then when we look at the revenues for the last year, Intel pulled in nearly $72 billion, and you would expect AMD to pull in around half of this, right? Because it is half the value of Intel. Well, not quite, because AMD only pulled in $6.7 billion in revenue last year. All of this trickles down to the bottom line as well, with around a whopping $21 billion, whereas AMD pulled in less than half a billion dollars. Here's a visual of Intel versus AMD's revenue growth over the last 9 years, and the difference is very obvious between the two. Intel has seen phenomenal growth, where AMD has lagged behind quite a bit. Similar story for net income. Intel has had phenomenal profits coming in consistently, but AMD has struggled to even turn a profit here. Clearly, from these metrics, one of these businesses is a profit machine, whereas the other is still in its early stages of possibly turning things around and becoming a long-term profit machine. However, the crazy part still remains. Intel is a $200 billion company and they pull in $21 billion in profits, whereas AMD is a $100 billion company and they don't even pull in half a billion dollars in profits. So something doesn't add up. Now, if you're an AMD shareholder, you're definitely thinking, Nick, this is backwards looking data. You're looking at 2019. AMD's future potential is where investors are excited about because they're going to grow at immense rates in the future. This will result with them being more profitable. This will result in them taking more market share from Intel. And as a result, AMD is the better long-term outlook here from this point on. This really made me think, guys, is AMD really going to eat up all of Intel's market share? I'll tell you this, as of today, I don't have a position in either of these two companies. So I'm pretty unbiased here with this. I'm just looking for the best investment out there. And after doing a bit of research on these companies and their market shares in general, I came across a website that compares this data quite well. So this is from the website CPU Benchmark, and they do a comparison of the overall market share of AMD versus Intel. And we can see that yes, Intel is losing market share while AMD gains market share, but overall Intel still holds just over 60% of the market. But now taking a step further, they compare desktop market share, and here it's pretty much neck at neck. AMD has stepped up their game here, and most consumers who are serious about building a desktop, specifically a gaming desktop, go to AMD's line of products. This clearly shows in the graph here over the years as AMD has picked up tons of market share. Then if we look at the laptop market share, AMD has started to climb, but there's still a massive gap here. Intel holds around 80% of this market, so they still have a very strong footing here, and this may trend down over time, but they are still the clear winner in this space. But now comes the exciting part, and that is the data center space. So you know that data center is pretty much the future, and that's because of cloud and the push towards cloud. So the requirements for data centers have risen significantly over the years, and what's used in these data centers? Servers. When we compare the server market here of Intel and AMD, it's not even close. Intel holds over 98% of the market over AMD, and this is something they have been a clear winner in. If they start losing ground here as well, this could result in a big sell-off. So keep a close eye on this. But as of right now, this is clear to me which of these two companies is the dominant player in this space. So what does all this data tell us? Well, it's clear that AMD is gaining footing when it comes to consumer products, especially with desktops. And I wouldn't be surprised to see them overtake Intel over the next few years. However, when it comes to other metrics like laptops or with servers, Intel still has a comfortable margin. And as long as they're able to keep executing and hopefully not delaying their products anymore, they should be able to maintain a good portion of that market in coming years. The recent run-up in AMD kind of tells me that investors are pricing in the possibility that AMD is actually going to steal a lot of this market share that they don't currently have, whereas Intel, the crash with Intel is mainly around that 7-nanometer delay, but that indirectly tells me that investors, they are expecting Intel to lose a market share here to AMD quite significantly. Not just my thoughts, I think that's what the market is kind of pricing in here. So if either of these companies don't deliver on what's expected, we could see some significant moves, not only in their share price, but in their competitor share price as well. Okay, so now let's jump back to the numbers here from a fundamental perspective to figure out, you know, investments, what's the better investment. Now here is where it gets exciting because we get into the nitty-gritty details of these two stocks. Looking at revenue growth estimates of 2021, Intel is actually expected to decline and net income is also expected to decline. AMD, on the other hand, is expected to grow well with over 22% revenue growth and a whopping 316% net income growth, which is very impressive on a percentage basis. This, however, guys, can be a bit skewed. This is because with even a 8% decline in net income, Intel will pull in around $20 billion in profits next year. AMD, on the other hand, even with their 316% of growth expected in net income, will only pull in around $1.5 billion of profits. So while AMD is growing rapidly, it's still nowhere near the amount of money that Intel pulls in. Now, free cash flow for these two businesses is also drastically different. Intel with almost $17 billion and AMD with under $300 million. Again, for gross margins, Intel's is higher at 57% versus AMD's 44%. And hey, if you're investing in these stocks for a dividend, Intel is the only option here because they pay out a 2.19% yield because they earn so much money. Now, I don't expect AMD to pay out a dividend for a very long time until they're really able to sustain billions in profits here consistently on a yearly basis like Intel does, and I don't think that's going to happen for at least a few years at minimum. So if you're an investor looking for dividends, it's clear which one is the better option. Now, the price to earnings, PE, and price to sales, PS ratios are also something that I like looking at. And Intel is a very cheap 8.85 PE versus AMD's astronomical 201 PE. Intel has a price to sales of 2.61 versus AMD's 13.31. Clearly, you're paying a massive premium to own AMD because it has growth potential, but is this premium justified? That's the million-dollar question. Finishing out the comparison here, assets of Intel sit at over $150 billion, with liabilities at $70 billion, so they have a rock-solid balance sheet. AMD has assets of $6.5 billion and liabilities of $3.2 billion, so from a ratio perspective, they are about the same, but from an actual dollar perspective, it's not even comparable. Now, I know I threw a ton of information at you, so if you're a bit lost, maybe pause the video, rewind a little bit, and just rewatch that section again, because those metrics are extremely important when comparing these two businesses. The conclusion that I can really draw is that the market is clearly expecting AMD to continue gaining market share and continue growing at these rapid clips, whereas it expects Intel to continue losing market share in most markets, if not all markets, which will result, of course, in less revenues and less profits. So in other words, I would say that AMD is kind of priced to perfection here with a $100 billion market cap, whereas Intel is kind of swept under the rug, if you will, and investors just throwing this aside and saying, this is not an investment I would ever consider. AMD is the best investment. And that's just kind of how the market is right now. And I mean, I can't really blame investors in Intel. They've delayed these things time and time again. They failed to execute on these things in a timely manner. And as a result, it's let AMD catch up to them over the years. Can they turn things around? I think that they can. Will they turn things around? That is something we're just gonna have to wait and see about. So really, bottom line, what is the better investment today? Is it Intel stock or is it AMD stock? Well, guys, you know me and you know that through and through, I'm pretty much a value investor. However, I will always consider a good growth stock. I do hold some growth stocks in my portfolio. I plan to expand that part of my portfolio. And I actually do love the returns that growth stocks provide you. So I'm not gonna rule out AMD on that aspect. However, to me, I think that AMD is just too richly valued at $100 billion. I think that everything has to execute perfectly for AMD to sustain this price. And if there's anything that comes out that isn't according to plan, maybe they lose money when they're expected to be profitable. Maybe they don't grow as fast as possible. Maybe Intel actually gets their act together, turn things around, and you know, start taking market share back from AMD. That will not bode well for AMD stock. And I can see that stock correcting quite significantly if those things happen. What I do like about Intel is that they provide stability. They still provide some growth over the long term. However, in the short term, it's not gonna happen. It's gonna be pretty much flat. But on the plus side, they do still provide you that dividend. So you're getting, you know, stability in your portfolio, you're getting exposure to semiconductors, and you're getting a dividend. So it's a good value stock here. I think that over the long term, Intel should still perform just fine. However, from this point on, I think that AMD may actually be the better performer. That does not mean that AMD stock is a better buy at these current prices. However, I do believe that the mentality of the stock market is kind of shifting more towards growth type tech stocks, and that's kind of exactly where AMD fits in. So I wouldn't be surprised to see the stock run up to a $200 billion market cap in some extreme irrational run. So I'm not going to say AMD is not a buy here at these prices. It's just not a stock that I would personally be buying at these prices. But regardless, bottom line, I want to hear from you guys and I want to know which of these two stocks you would be buying. I know most of you guys are in the AMD camp. I know a lot of you already opened a position in Intel because of the discount, but let me know in the comment section down below between these two companies which is the better investment for you. And also, guys, let me know if this kind of video was helpful and it was informative. I do want to make one, like I said, on Visa and MasterCard, and if that interests you, let me know in the comment section down below as well. Either way, thank you so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to invest positively, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.